We're just going to make a little platform so we can roll our 14 gauge wire on. You can see here. It's 14 gauge galvanized. It's a quarter mile long. We're just making chainmail. And got a little section going on here, but we're using a 3/8 inch dowel rod, and I'm just going to drill a hole in it. Okay,
that a half inch?
It's I don't know, it's 3/8.
Put a hole in your table, Joe.
I'm just going halfway in this one. Just enough to keep it in there. We may have to do some wallowing around so that our dowel rod will fit through, and it fits in fine. There you go. Keeping it here, in here, because we'll put it in here. Now I'm just going to pre-drill me two holes in either side and screw it together, and we'll get back with you shortly. Okay, here we are with the finished product. I mean, obviously it's just a board, two smaller ones. I got a 3/8 hole drilled in one and halfway through the other. There's a 3/8 inch dowel rod with 3/32 hole drilled completely through it for the 14 gauge wire to go in. And got a battery operated drill. So, like I said, we got a quarter mile of 14 gauge galvanized stainless steel or galvanized wire. Get this big puppy up here. Show you what it looks like. So, like I said, a quarter mile. I don't know if you can get that or not. It's galvanized 14 gauge electric fence wire. And then we have a 100-foot, same gauge, 14 gauge, that we have been making chainmail with. We're doing 4-to-1 ratio on it. You see how tight that is? Very nice. It's got some weight to it, just this little bits. Slight, you know, kind of heavy. So here we go. Let's go ahead and put him in here. And just set him down and just...
You have a hard time with this.
Wow. Oh, that's okay. It'll...
shot up. That'll have a spindle to.
Right. There we go.
Wow.
So for future references, don't cut off 100-foot and do it. Just do it straight off the spool. And it's best if it's on 6. If you have settings, that way you can open it up.
But that was a mess.
We'll go ahead and cut him from there if you want.
Yeah, we can do that.
And the tin snips work the best out of all of them. Simply because you can cut him here too if you want to.
Sorry.
Alright, let me pull this out. And then we're ready to start cutting this out with our tin snips. And with the tin snips, we get anywhere from 4 to 6 per cut. If there's a way to, you can string this up, because every time you cut, this will fall down. And it's not that hard of a cut. You see how many I got cut one whack? 5. Like I said, it's 14 gauge. And I'll get this cut up and we'll count the lengths and show you how many that we got out of just that little bit. Stay tuned. Okay, out of that little coil that we just made, about 70 links in under 3 minutes. You know, that's with the tin snips. And this one here is all three ways cutting it, left, right, and straight. And these are the straight ones. And it doesn't really matter. I've tried both of them. So at 70 links in under 3 minutes, I have just that little bit of coil that we used that you've seen on video previous. So I'm going to make another coil and just do the redundancy over and over and over. Okay, here we're using setting 1, wide open.
Spinning in the drill. Wait, it's caught behind my hand. Okay, go. It was too. I was pulling on it too hard, I think. Wow, that's tight. Other way, turn it the other way. There you go.
We went ahead and cut up all the coils from the 100 foot. What you see in this bag is 104. And here we got a total of 700 3/8 links in the lot. That's a 14 gauge galvanized steel. And we got a quarter of a mile to go.
Alright, well, after the coiling and cutting, now we get these little rings, which all you do is put them together with a pair of pliers. So they're one whole thing, simple. And then you also want to keep some spread open so you can set foreign on it for the foreign one. Now, after you got a bunch of those, you gotta connect them together. Now we have two of those little 4-in-1 connections, and you want to make sure that they're all going in the same direction. Like, see how these are all going in this direction, these middle ones are all going in one direction. Now you want to get another one with a gap. And you just put it through. And you want to try to follow the same pattern. So they're all going in the same direction. And you lay it out and you got your first little link. And then you link two of those together. And then you just keep going.